Hello everyone, welcome in a new stream. First I have to open it so I can read the chat again. Yes, it's open. Yesterday I started this page in the Kirby new book, Fragile World, and I will continue coloring this page. A little disclaimer at the beginning of the stream, because I have one of my kids at home homeschooling, so if you hear any noises, or he is home, maybe he needs a little help and I have to stop streaming, but we will see how it's going. Today I will color the background, and yesterday I didn't know what colors I want to use, if I wanted gray or brown rocks. But when I looked at the picture, they live on rocks with a cream color. So I think I will go with it and see if I'm able to copy the colors, because I really like how the bird is turning out so far. I color today with the polygomos again. I picked up a cream and an ivory and some Michibichi pencils, a beige color, 520 in the regular set, and then two pencils from the limited set, and that is color 48 and 49. So I will use them on the background on rocks and see how it is going. Maybe I can zoom in a little bit. I think I will start with this section. Let me see. Can I zoom in? Yes. So, better. Hello Connie, welkom. I think I will start with a beige color. How are you today, Connie? Oh, I think I have to sharpen. It's a very blunt pencil. You can see, I only use it for a swatch card, so I use the Bruinzeel sharpener, and I think it needs some new blades because it chipped off a little bit of the point, but because I'm streaming, I don't like to use the electric sharpener. It makes a lot of noise in the stream, so I start with a little layer. Thank you, Connie. It was so much fun to color the birds, and it was kind of easy. I used the reference picture, and yeah. That helped me a lot. I hope you are okay today. And I think you will stream later this evening. Oh, snapped off my pencil. I hope you are able to see the light layers. Because I don't think it will show up on camera, but there is a very light layer of the beige color. And I like to build up my colors with the polygomos and the Michibichis. I'm okay today. had a very nice, relaxed morning. Did some more jigsaw puzzling. We are making a huge one. Mickey Mouse jigsaw. Together with my kids. I started this morning alone. They had to do their school and homework. And I think one and a half more weeks, and then we are finished with the puzzle. Okay, that's nice. In 4 hours, you have a new time that you stream. I think I will add in some gray. In the shadows that Kirby already gave me. Every day. What do you mean, Connie? I have one of my kids home now because there was the virus in the classroom, in the group. Also, the teacher is infected. We heard it yesterday evening. So he has to stay home till next week, at least. The other is at school. I don't know how long he is able to go, but I'm happy he is at school now. You are back to afternoon streaming. Yeah, that is very nice. Most of the time I am preparing dinner when I'm watching your stream, and that's nice. Easier for me than the evening streams. I'm always very tired when you stream late, and it's hard for me to watch the whole stream. And I don't know if I like this color palette that is in the pictures. Maybe I will go for more grayish rocks, but we will see in the end. I was thinking about brown rocks before, and then I was afraid that my bird will disappear. So I don't know. I use the olive now. And I will go switch to the dark olive. Because in the picture it shows a little more green than gray on the darker spots. And yeah, I will try. Maybe it needs a little bit more orangey in the rocks too. I never used this color, so I don't know how it will turn out. And most of the times when you try something new on stream, it will be failing, but that's okay. It's a learning curve. At least my bird's looking okay. So yeah, I have one boy at home and one at school. I'm happy one is home, and it's the oldest. My 10-year-old, so he's able to do his own things and follow his online lessons. Now I have some time to stream. Hubby just left to work, so yeah, that's life, what's going on here. It is beautiful weather today, so I had a little walk with the dogs already this morning. I don't know if I like the colors on this one. There is so much color that is not showing up on the stream. Yes, I love the pollies on the paper. I did the jaguar also with pollies. I really enjoyed coloring it, and everything is pollies with a little touch of the Michibichis. You can see the paper is great. I don't use any watercolor or no base, just pollies. So I really enjoyed it. Maybe I have to close some blinds. I can try. Oh no, I don't have the blinds on there. Maybe this is helping to show the color a little more. I hope. So yeah, I really like use pencils in the books. It takes some time. Yesterday I finished just one word on stream and one half. And at the opposite page I colored more birds. And this one is not finished yet. I don't know. I was not feeling it anymore to color yesterday, so I had to stop. The jaguar took me around 40 hours. I started just before the Easter weekend and finished it after. I had a very good time. And the funny thing is that I didn't color any a bunny or spring picture yet this year, so I'm always very excited to color the flowers and the bunnies and the cute animals, and then there is spring and I don't color anything. And it's the same with the winter or Christmas pictures. Last year I only finished one. And I was very excited to be able to color Christmas. So maybe I have to color Christmas earlier, starting November, or when I really want to. And not wait till it's the Christmas time. Like now with the bunnies and spring pictures. I like to color this one now. I switch to a gray again. And I think it needs a lot of more layers. More greens and olive and I'm not happy that it's not showing on the camera. So now you have to watch me color and didn't see anything change. Last week I did a lot of flip-throughs because I like to first making the video of the flip-through before I finish a page in a book. So when I'm just messed up the page, then it's not in the flip-through video. And I filmed some, and now I finally can start coloring also in my new Japanese books that I got for my birthday. I cannot wait to start. You can see it. Okay, that's good. I think it's a strange color rock in the picture, but maybe it will turn out beautiful. I don't know. And maybe it's once in a lifetime and I never will color this kind of rock again. We will see. And you can hear the difference between the Polygonos pencils and the Michibichi pencils. Hey, welcome, Pat. Yeah, that's a great idea. Christmas in July. Every year, that's one funny story. We celebrate Christmas in July. My husband's birthday is the 1st of July, and he don't like celebrate his birthday. So we did it now for 3 years in a row, Christmas in July, and then we have Christmas paper and presents and for the family, and it's so much fun. We prepare some Christmas dinner and yeah, really celebrate it. Everyone is always thinking we are strange by doing it, but it's so much fun to celebrate Christmas. And we put on some Christmas music and watch some Christmas movie, play some games, and yeah, really enjoying the Christmas vibe in the middle of the summer. I'm not someone that is enjoying summer. I really don't like the hot weather and being able to get in the Christmas mood. It makes me happy. Yes, it was an amazing picture, Connie colored in the calendar. I think it's that one you are talking about. Connie is a great colorist. She will be streaming later today. I think you are knowing that, I need some more olive color. I will take a look in my color Bible, so I call it that way. I swatched out all my color pencils that I own, and I will have a look in my Polychromos chart for some colors that I like on the page. Maybe I think I can use this one, the olive green, or the, yes, this one. It's a hard one. Yes, but I don't know if we celebrate Christmas all year long. Let me pick up some pencils. This is the wrong one. If we celebrate the Christmas all year long, if will it be that much fun? I don't know. Because it's not that special anymore. And I just enjoy it. Something odd to do. And I'm just an odd person. Yesterday, Kenny told me she was a little too late for the stream. I just ended it and she saw the notification. And so I hope that Kenny is able to catch a stream today. I started the stream 2 hours later, so I hope she's able to. Would be fun. I think it's the first time then. This is, I can show you, a cape, a rock jumper, and the bird, I used a reference picture, let me find it, this is the bird, how it's looking, so you can see the cream rocks I try to make now, and there is some green and yeah, on camera you cannot see it very well, but this is the bird and I try to copy it. And I like a little bit more green on the rocks because otherwise I think it will be very flat coloring. You like the winter the best. Yeah, I think the winter is just a little too cold. I like the fall the best. With rain. I love rain. And being inside and getting cozy. All the candles lit. And oh, I like it so much. I also like to walk in the rain. Yes, it is hard to copy the rocks, I know, and I don't think it will turn out perfect, but as long as I'm happy, I'm okay. And I think I use too many yellow colors, so maybe I can add some Holbein shades of peachy colors. They have amazing pastel range of colors. I always can add it in later. So I will base it with a beige color in the Michibichi set. And I always use a lot of different pencil brands in my pictures. Before I always used one type of pencil and now I'm looking for the colors. What I can use. The only thing I don't like to use together is the Prismacolors and the Polychromos. Or the Prismas and the Pablos. I don't like to use them together. Because they have a very different feel while coloring. And I like to use the Polychromos by building up and layers and layers. And the Prismas I use more for the blending on different type of paper. I'm sorry, I was reading the chat. It's so nice to have people in the chat. I really appreciate it, people that's being here in the live stream and talking and watching, support me. Makes streaming a lot more fun to do. I will add in some cream. This month I colored already 4 pages in 4 different books. And some in untouched books. I really enjoy the hashtag by Lovella that she is having the all year. She wants to color in all her untouched books, and yeah, I like to give all my books a little love. So yesterday I picked out another book and I started A Mermaid. I have it downstairs. Sometimes I like to color on my bed, and then I have a little wooden table so I can sit and color. Hallo, welkom. Leuk je weer te zien. I don't know. Will I get the layers with all of first? Yes, I think so, and I think I will just add in more green at some places and more gray at others to don't make it the same all over the page. I don't know if you can see the difference between this part where I added the green more and the gray. And I think I will switch to some grass and plants later. Doing a pencil background or a page only in pencil takes a long, long time. Yes, I'm in the Netherlands. I think you can hear it. The way I speak English. It's kind of hard for me to color and think about the colors and translate everything that I want to say. And some days it's easier for me to talk English than others, but I will try. I really enjoy the company in the streams all over the world, and yeah, come together. I think I will add in some black, and maybe that will give it a little bit more depth. Ah, oh, that's nice. Is he on holiday or school? Living there? Yes, some days are more difficult to talk. Especially when you have a lot on your mind, or when you are tired, or sometimes you just cannot find the words you want to say, and can be frustrating. Connie is also in the Netherlands. So she understands the struggle with the streaming in a different language. Yes, exactly. When you are done streaming, you know all the words that you were searching for and the things that you wanted to say, and yeah, and when you were streaming, you lost your words, and well, that's okay. They are living here, that's great. I think Amsterdam is very busy place to live. There's always something going on. A lot of tourists always around all year long. Well, not now with the virus, but otherwise. I think I will have to look for some peachy colors. This is the Pablo set, but I will first take a look in the Polychromos. Maybe I can add in very lightly the dark chrome yellow. Maybe. I will try and I will try. Let me see. Oh no, it's getting more yellow. I don't want that. This cadmium orange color. I want to try this one, a little light layer. Not exactly what I wanted. But it's okay. Otherwise, I have to pick out my Holbeins, I think. We will roll with it. De Leidse Gracht. Oké. Then they don't need any television. They can watch outside and see a lot happening all day long, the nights. I think there are always people around there. I don't know if you can see the difference. It's very white here, only I added some colors. Also, in you, the webcam is not picking it up, so there is more color. I don't know how to show it. See? There are more colors on the page. But if I turn the lights off, you are not able to see anything, so I'll leave it on. This part already have a base of the beige color. Beige color. I decided yesterday that I wanted to stream again today. And when I woke up, I really wanted to stream straight away, but I waited till hubby left for work and yeah, it's better. I had to think about how to tackle the rocks. And I'm still not really happy. It's hard when you have a picture in mind and when you color and it don't turn out the way you had imagined it, especially on the stream. Sometimes you just leave the page and come back to it a week, week later, and then you know how to finish it or get the results you really was hoping for. But I don't want to walk away from it now. So I keep trying. I think in the end it will be beautiful. I just say it will be beautiful and that will happen. Let me see. I switch around with all the green tones in the Polygonos range. If you are wondering. Let me see. You can see the numbers here that I use. And then I add in some of the Michibichi colors. But the most of them are Polychromos by Faber-Castell. I told yesterday that they were my first artist grade pencils and that I really enjoy them because they holding their points very long. And I have my set since 2015 and I just replaced a couple, some of the ivory and cream colors I already replaced and some greens, but the most of them are still half of the pencil left. That's very nice. It's better than the Luminance or the Prismas. I burn through them very fast. Especially when you color hair or something, then you want a very nice sharp point and you keep sharpening. And yeah, it's great to use the polys for it. I'll have to tone it down a little with the cream. Someday I really want to try some of the Artesa pencils. I hear a lot about mixed reviews about them. Some people like them, some people don't. And the same with the new Derwent Chromaflow. I really want to try them. I love Derwent pencils most of the time. So yeah. Now the other side, I have so many pencil brands and I really don't need any more sets. I just want them. Yeah, it is what it is. It's a truth. Yes, with a little of the orange color, I like it more. You like the police. Don't have the Holbeins. Yeah, I have Holbeins. Don't use them a lot. I just found out that we can buy them open stock now, order them in the Netherlands. So I think I will use them more now. I was afraid that I was not able to replace any, and that's something I don't like. I don't have them, the Brood Funners. I don't know if Connie... Yeah, Connie, you have them, right? I think. I still miss some of the luminance colors. They have 100 colors now, I think. And I miss 4 of the open stock ones. And the art shop where I most of the time shop don't have the new colors at all. So when I place an online order, I think I will add them to my shopping cart. You got them last week, yeah. Do you like them? Did you try them already? And you cannot buy them open stock, right? It's coming along now. I think it's adding more of the different colors will bring the rock alive. Adding in some more black in the shadows. And you have the lumens, yes, they are amazing. I really like the lumens. And buying them open stock is cheaper, I think. Also than getting the whole set. That's a strange thing about lumens. I just replaced some of the colors, some skin tones, and the buff titanium I had to replace. I will add in some sepia to give it a little bit more warmth. This is a very small pencil, but I have some backups already. The paper is peeling here. I don't know if you can see it, but I damaged it. I think I did too many layers. It's almost go through. And that is someone at the door. I don't know if my son is opening the door. Ja, kijk maar wie dat is, lieverd. Maybe I have to go downstairs. I don't know. I think it's the mailman. It's something for the neighbors. I didn't order anything, so no surprises. Wie was dat? Oké, dank je. Helemaal goed. Yes, the mailman. It's something for the neighbors. That was a good thing that he's home now. So he was able to open the door. Oh, you like them? Oh no, I don't want to hear that you like it. Oh, it's great when we enjoy our pencils and yeah. I love watching the streaming. You showed all your pencils. And I saw some pencils that I don't have. And I really can enjoy that. Seeing other gems. I think I get used to the rocks now. Now I'm further into the page. Even Kirby didn't draw in some shading, I will add in some. Thank you. They are very inexpensive, yes. Well, that's the point also. I have so many pencils and I always pick up the same brand to color with, like my Polys or Prismas in some books, or Lightfast or Lumis or Hobies. Or and when you have so many pencils, sometimes you forget about the set that you really like. There is just not enough time, and yeah. Oh, enjoy your walk, Connie. And I see you in a few hours in your stream. Bye. As you can see, I have a book, my Bible, coloring Bible full of swatches. I can show you. If I'm able to find how I can zoom. Yes. Oops. It's better. So I have the Polys and this is only my color pencils. I also have watercolor pencils and I just started to swatch my pastel pencils. So I have the Polys in here. I have the Pablo set. Charisma, Charisma, Luminance, so really I don't need any, the Holbies, Michibichi, 100 set and the 240 set, then I have all the sets of the Black Widows, the Castle Arts, the Tombows. I really don't like the Tombows. They are too hard for my taste. Then the Koh-i-Noor Magic. Progresso. The Polycolors. Lightfast. Metallics. Drawing. Studios. Artists. Colorsoft. This is the old Rexel Darren set, the studio ones, and they have a lot of more pigment than the studio ones we now have. You can see the difference. It's a huge difference, the old formula. Procolor, Signatures, These are the old light vest set by Derwent. They have very nice muted colors. The ones that are in the drawing set are very close to this signature set. And then I also have a huge with all my watercolor pencils and yeah. So I have enough pencils, really. I don't need any more. I don't, but yeah. Sometimes it's very tempting. And some people are showing off their beautiful, yeah, showing off, it's not the right word, but showing and their new goodies, and then, yeah. Connie enables me a lot. She really does. I think it's okay with yellow, golden, rocks, something different. First I was not sure, but yeah, I think I like it. I will base down something under the bird. I won't stream every part of the rock because there's a lot of rock going on the page. Just this little section, and then I will think about the vegetation, I think it's called. The little grass and the flowers and the things. The blick, yeah. You sent back. Okay, I like the Pablos a lot. They knit a lot of layers, the same as the Prismas. I like them together, the Pablos and the, not the Prismas, the Pullies, I mean. I like them together. And I like to base down with the watercolor pencils, the Supracolor, I think it's called. I like to base down and then add in the Pablos, because they have the same color range. And then you can add in shades, and it's very easy to color. That's why I like the watercolor pencils from the, not the Luminance set, but the, how do you call them? What's the name? They are, and they have similar colors to the Luminance. Oh my. Museum Aquarelle, I think it's the name of the set. And I like them together with the Luminance pencils. So I base down something with a Museum Aquarelle, and then I will add in the shades. Sometimes I use the Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer pencils together with the Polychromos, and here I have enough pencils. But I love the square ones, the look of them. I also like the other square ones. It's a set of 500. Yes, I think. And it's a subscription pencil. So you will get every month some pencils. And they are also square. But yeah, when you have a lot of sets, you really don't need another set. If that makes sense. But it can be, it can make you happy, and yeah, I don't know. I think it is the Felissimo set, the huge set of 500 pencils. But they are very expensive to get, to ship to the Netherlands. And I like it more to get a set, a huge set in one time, the complete set. and not being able to order them open stock. I don't like that part. Yes, lovely pastel pencils. I like the colors, but I don't know about the pigments in the pencils. Because when I see someone coloring, the colors are not very bright, I think, vivid. They are just like the Tombow pencils, I think. I don't know. I haven't used them, so I really cannot tell you. Well, maybe someday I will add them to my collection. And we will see. For now, it's okay. I added some new pencils, I think 2 weeks ago. My hubby got me the Faber-Castell Pitt pastel pencils. It's a very nice set. I haven't used them yet, so. Yes, they are flat colors. I don't know. And I like if you layer up your colors, that they will be very nice. That you get a rich color. Like the bird. If it makes sense. And not that if you will color and it is very flat and pastel looky, and sometimes it's nice, but sometimes I don't like it. Depending on the page, I think. Not in wildlife. I really enjoy coloring animals and flowers. And no, that is not any stress. I think it is Felissimo. They have a very nice color range. I have a very huge set of pencils. 240. And I think it's not hard to pick any colors. At the other side, you don't need so many colors. You can mix color pencils very easily and layer up. Or blend them together to get the color you want. So there is no need to get a huge set. But I love to have a huge set. I know there are some amazing colorists and that they can make almost every color. Making portraits with just the blue. The red, the yellow, the black and the white. I think there are some videos on YouTube. And I was amazed when I was watching it. How they are able to blend and layer. And yes, it's great. Just a little bit more of the orangey color. And then I like to color some of the grass. And in the picture, all the grass and the things are very, I think, from creamy. There is not much of the green grass going on here. But I think I really want the green more than the yellow. I think. Let me see. Maybe I can find some different pictures also. Yes, I like it more with some green, with dark green. So I will use the dark green. Yes, you only get a set of 20 pencils a month, I think, and it's a subscription and you can not cancel it. And I don't like that part, that you are not able to cancel it. And every time you get a package. Oh, I love fall colors. And every time you get the package arrived, then you have to pay the import fees and yes, everything. There's something I don't like about the Felissimo pencil subscription. I add in the May green. No, the earth yellowish earth green and the May green. I will combine them. I think the colors are too much spring vibe. It's too bright. So I will add in some more olive green to make it more cohesive with the page. So that it is a green one. But not that bright. Maybe it needs a little bit more of the dark green. Think it is called pine green in the Polychromos set. I will see. And for some reason, this type of flower, it is screaming to some muted pink colors. I don't know why, but in real they are more yellow and beige colors. Let me see. Maybe this one. The paper in this book is just taking around 5 to 6 layers. So that's something that you have to keep in mind. This is not a paper that you can layer and layer and layer. Maybe I use too much pressure. Thank you for being here. Hope you have a great day. Bye. I was not looking at chat for a while. The page is talking to me. Yes, maybe. I'm talking to myself most of the time when I'm streaming. Maybe I have to get friends with the page. Let me see. Just a fast base with a May green. And then the yellowish earth green. And I like the, I don't know, which one? The more green color, I think. Sometimes it is very easy to pick the colors. When you see a page, you know exactly what colors you like to use. And sometimes it is very hard to choose some color palette that you want to use in the page. And when I have trouble, sometimes I will just take a look in my swatches, or I take a look in a book with color palettes. I can pick it to show you. Let me see. I have a very nice book with color palettes. It's this one. And it has so many colors, how they use them together. And there's a picture with the colors they have used, and then the combinations, how to use the colors and the results you are getting. And sometimes it is so easy to just take a look and pick out a color palette to use in the page. I have some flecked for some spring pictures, because I always tend to use some of the fall colors. Yes, I really like this book. I am enjoying it. And sometimes I use some reference pictures for the colors, like today. And I like to give it my own twist also. I think I will add in some pink, some muted pink colors. It's a very nice book with the color palettes. And I know you can find on internet a lot of the palettes too. I am just someone that really loves to the feel of a real book. I picked up some muted colors in the set, some skin tones, the light flesh, the cinnamon, burnt carmine, and see what I will create. They are also beautiful when done in the lavender colors, the violet colors. I think they will be beautiful. And I don't know why, but my colors are very muted today on the screen. Yes, I think I like it with the pink tones. As you can see, I hop around at the page while I'm coloring. a base it down with the lightest skin tone color in the polychromo set. Then the burnt carmine color. I haven't replaced any of these pencils yet. And they are still pretty long size pencil, and I use them very regularly. Oh my gosh. I have some trouble speaking today. The darkest red violet. And then the cinnamon. Maybe a little cream. Yes, thank you. I like it if there are some focal points in the picture. Because there are a lot of rocks, and if everything is this creamy, green, brownish color going on the page, it is nice to have some brighter colors popping out of it, I think. And you can add a little of the Posca on the tips of the flower to make it very popping out. You can see the difference. Sometimes I really like doing that. I don't know if it is showing up very well, but I can see it. And I don't think these are meant to be flowers. But I make them into flowers. Because it's my coloring book and I do what I want to. And I think making them purple are also very beautiful. And then contrasting against the yellow, I think the purple flowers will be standing out a little bit more. Yes, most of the time I use the Posca's at the end, and like I did in the Jaguar page, underwater. And that make the water pop out. Just all this is with the gel pens, and it makes a huge difference on the page. I just saw on Insta someone posted a picture with a face and white out all the lines, and it was beautiful. I think it was coloring F. Frances. that colored the page with a face in an Anna Carlson book. And I really like the result of it. I'm searching in the page for different things to color so that I don't show the same thing over and over and over again in the stream. And that I'm able to finish the page the same way that I colored it in the stream. And that if you want, you also can follow the stream and using it in the whole page. If I don't, and I just start coloring the page on the stream, then it will be really taking hours and hours and hours and hours to finish a page. And I don't think someone will watch it and enjoy it. If I remember, I can post her name at the end of the stream. She is also on YouTube. Making coloring videos and finished pages and I will try at the Posca to see if I can see it on this flower more. Maybe my Posca is running low. I don't know. Maybe. And I saw very huge one. I will color this also pink. Another one. Some of this will all be green grass with a yellow green rocks. And then we have some branches all across the page. And I think I will make them very dark. I have a lot of pencils out now. Let me see. I have the Noga, Burnt Umber and the Sepia for the branches. And I will use just brown. Because I use so many green colors already in the rocks. Otherwise, I like to add in some green in the branches. Let me see. Always difficult to color in the spine. It's easier when you base with watercolors, with neo colors. It's easier to get in the spine and you won't notice that much if you are not going over with a color pencil. Just very fast base. And I don't know what to do with the sky yet. I don't know if I want to use the color pencils or just a light layer of the pompastel or watercolor. Or I don't know yet. Maybe I will color some sunset with some pinky orange sky or just a light blue sky. Or I don't know. When I mess it up, I most of the time just black it out, throw in some stars, and I'm happy with it. But I try to color less black backgrounds lately. But it's hard because I kind of like the look of the black backgrounds. I'm just switching between the brown colors. I'm just adding a little bit of the cream. I don't know if I have to zoom in a little bit more. If you are able to see it very well. It's very tiny. I have to make sure that I'm not out of frame. And I think my 10-year-old is done with his schoolwork. I can hear him walking the stairs.
Hij schat.
Ben je klaar? Ja.
Nou, wacht maar totdat die broer thuis is. Nou, samen. Ja?
I'm not a background person either. I think coloring backgrounds is a lot of work. And most of the time I don't like the results I create. And then I black it out. Making black skies is always looking very great. But it's kind of an easy way out for me now. That's a thing that I don't like about it. So I will challenge myself to do more backgrounds. In the Hannah Carlson books, I really like to use the neo colors for backgrounds. But after 10 pages with the same technique, I didn't like it that much anymore. To create, I like the look of it. Still, Well, sometimes I just don't know what I want. And I think coloring backgrounds, it is just so much time. Same with the Jaguar page, I spent so many hours just on the background. And I was building very slowly the colors. And sometimes that is very relaxing, but sometimes you just want the quick results and get the page done. And sometimes I just leave the background blank. I did it in the Joanna Bashford new book. I just left it blank. I was not inspired to color anything in the background. Or even black it out. I don't have distress inks. I saw Karen coloring with distress inks, and it was so stunning. I really liked it. But on the other side, do I need another medium to color it? Yeah, I want it, but do I need it? I don't think so. So that's the... I like to use at the moment what I have. I have seen people using the inks as a base and then just a little bit of color pencil on top, and the pages looked so amazing. You can see I go out of the line sometimes, but it's okay. In the beginning of my coloring journey, I was thinking that it was horrible when you go out of the lines. And I was thinking that I feel the page when I go out of the lines. At the moment, I don't worry about it anymore. And if I go out of the lines, it is what it is, and I deal with it. Because sometimes the pencils are just too tiny, or you are not able to see it very well in difficult places. So. And then I color outside of the lines. Sometimes I'm able to fix it with the paint, sometimes I don't. And it's all okay, as long as I'm enjoying. I have around 10 minutes left to stream before my other boy is coming home. And then I will end the stream. And I don't know if I'm able to be back tomorrow or not. We will see. I don't think so. I think that my husband is home tomorrow. And then I don't want to scream. Yeah, I think I like it so far. With the rocks. And the flowers and the birds. And the dark branches. I think that will be very nice against the lighter rocks. Yes, life comes first, and sometimes I stream a few days in a row, and sometimes I cannot stream for a month, and yeah, that's why I don't have a set time to stream. I would love to have a set time like most of the streamers, but I don't have it. It's not working for me. Sometimes my pain levels won't let me stream, and I don't want to disappoint people that are then expecting a stream from me. So yeah, that's why I don't have a set time. Yesterday someone asked me about it. So yeah, I just pop on when I'm able to, when I feel like it, and it is enjoyable for me. And if I don't, then I'm not streaming. The thing I try to do every week is a flip through Friday. So there will be tomorrow a new flip through of a book. And I don't know which exactly will be online. I flipped some of the new Japanese books, so you can expect them in the next month or two. I flipped some Rita Berman books. They are really great color. I think I have flipped this one, but I really don't know the exact dates that they are online. So keep an eye out if you like it. Thank you. I'm happy that you like it. I cannot wait to see the result of the page. When it's all done. Sometimes I'm just a little impatient. And I think it will be come together very nice. When it's all done, and I really enjoy this book. I love this book. Thank you. That is very nice. I really enjoy it if you are here and that I have someone to talk to. And I love it that people are watching it back. And yeah. I appreciate it. I think the color community is very nice. So I think I have tackled everything in the page. I can zoom out. Let me show. Oh. Yes. I zoomed out. So I think I've tackled everything. The little part of the rocks, and I will just use the green in the shadow areas like Kirby drew in. You can see here the shadows. I will add in the green glow, and the rest will be the yellow orangey look. Then there are the little flowers, and there are some more. I will color it like this. All the crests I will color the same that I colored this, And I will finish the page in my own time. You can see everything is just the same as I showed. And I will finish it in my own time and show you in a stream later. Or on Instagram, I post my completed pages. So I will thank you all for watching and I hope you all enjoyed it. And I hope to see you very soon and have a great day. Bye!